these vast new realities. Follow me and ponder the question. What if?
So what if T'Challa was Star-Lord was the scenario we were presented with this week in Marvel's What If? And it was a really interesting episode and definitely more wacky and more out there and more like the kind of the random ramifications of T'Challa becoming Star-Lord, much more so than last week, which last week I still really enjoyed, but last week's definitely had that problem of kind of feeling like we were just rewatching Captain America the First Avenger, except with Peggy Carter in the role of Captain America. This week definitely felt more like there's a lot of differences now that T'Challa is Star-Lord instead of Peter, but also it was just really kind of bittersweet and sad to see Chadwick Boseman back as T'Challa or doing the voice of T'Challa. It was great to see him back, I guess great to hear his voice again, and the kind of the rest in peace bit at the end was also really emotional, but it was kind of really nice that his final appearance is showing the good impact T'Challa had in the universe now that he was Star-Lord, because Peter Quill, this kind of emphasizes that Peter Quill isn't the best person, that, you know, when he became Star-Lord, he was still very much a robber and a thief, and he was even stealing from the Ravagers himself. Like, when he got the orb from Morag, he was just going to hide that from Yondu and just go off his own way, sell it to the Collector, sell it to somebody rather than Yondu himself and just make money off of it. Whereas here, it's kind of being hammered home constantly that, sure, while the Ravagers are thieves, T'Challa is really making a difference for the good in the universe. So that was really cool as well. Really look forward to getting any deeper into this. I just want to ask if you can subscribe if you're not already. I make Marvel and DC videos every single week, and new subscribers really do help to keep up the motivation to make new videos. But yeah, it was great to see that, you know, T'Challa has an impact on the universe in a good way. A few minor complaints is that I did think it was a little bit strange that there were so many characters showing up or characters tied into this that otherwise wouldn't have been. It really did at one point feel like we were just seeing kind of familiar face after familiar face after familiar face, or Easter egg after Easter egg after Easter egg. Like seeing in the Collector's collection that he had just all the weapons we'd seen from across the MCU. Like he had Malekith's dagger, he had Hela's helmet, he had Captain America's shield, he had Thor's hammer. It felt like that was a little bit strange. Just because Peter Quill isn't Star-Lord, that the Collector would get all of this stuff from across the universe. That was something that felt like, okay, well, they could have dialed that back. They could have made that kind of not as in-your-face sort of thing. But Thanos, it was interesting to see that he was now a good guy. It was kind of funny to constantly hear people be like, that sounds a lot like genocide. And he's like, no, it's random. It's not genocide. I love that he was kind of getting annoyed at Korath as well for calling him genocidal maniac and stuff. And Korath was great as well. Korath was probably the most changed from the movies, where in the movies he's straight up just like, he works for Ronan, he's kind of an asshole. When he hears Star-Lord, he's like, who? And whereas this, he's more like, he's more kind of wholesome, where he's like, Star-Lord is my friend and stuff like that. That was kind of really nice. I did appreciate that change. I thought it was a cool thing to do. Another minor complaint is that it doesn't make a whole lot of sense that T'Challa calls himself Star-Lord in this, considering that in the MCU or in the Sacred Timeline, Peter Quill gets the name Star-Lord from Meredith Quill, aka his mother. So it's a little bit weird that T'Challa would also call himself Star-Lord with really no ties to the Quills or that. Speaking of the Quills, I really like the ending where we got to see Peter Quill in present day. Now that Ego is showing up, I was actually kind of wondering if we were going to see Peter Quill. I didn't think we would. I thought they would kind of stay the whole time in space or whatever. Also, at the end, we pretty much got confirmation from the Watcher himself that this is going to be a story that is continuing down the line. And probably this season, honestly, because in the trailer, there is a shot where we see T'Challa's Star-Lord, like, with Gamora and some other characters kind of standing in a very Avengers-esque circle. I'm assuming we're going to see that, where it's going to be like, T'Challa and the Ravagers are the Avengers basically now of this universe with a Gamora. I was also wondering where was Gamora, where was Rocket, where was Groot. So I'm assuming we're going to see that all of that answered in a future episode, probably towards the end of the season, maybe next episode. I'm not entirely sure though. I think they're going to have a couple scenarios that are different to one another. Then in the back half of the season, they're going to kind of show us the second half of some of these storylines. I was thinking at first they were not just going to do this, and instead of having season two, we were going to see like the follow-up to Captain Carter and maybe the follow-up to this, but I'm guessing they're going to be doing this in the same season, which I'm not sure if I'm crazy about that. I think it would have been cool to see a bunch of random scenarios and then next season follow up on the ones that deserve to be followed up on, but it was cool nonetheless. But yeah, we just saw the return of so many characters. We saw the return of the Black Order, saw the return of Howard the Duck, saw the return of the Collector, of Karina. It was kind of cool that Karina betrayed the Collector in both the Sacred Timeline and in this universe. Like, in this universe, she uses that gauntlet thingy, and in the Sacred Timeline, she kind of grabbed the Power Stone when it was taken out of the orb, kind of to be like, I'm not your servant anymore, or whatever. That was pretty cool. They also saved Cosmo, the space dog, who was also in the movies, which was kind of cool to see that come back. But I also love that Robin Hood is basically T'Challa's Kevin Bacon, because in the movies, Kevin Bacon is like Peter's hero or whatever, and that's why he's so obsessed with Footloose and Dance Office and stuff, whereas in this, T'Challa's obsessed with Robin Hood. So it makes sense that Peter being obsessed with Kevin Bacon would be much more focused on serving himself and doing things for himself, whereas T'Challa kind of being really, really, really obsessed with Robin Hood, whereas Robin has like steal from the rich, give to the poor, it makes sense that T'Challa is much more of a good guy in this kind of scenario. You also saw T'Chaka, Taserface, Kraglin, got references to Skrulls. There were so many Easter eggs in this episode. At one point, I did kind of feel like the Easter eggs sort of needed to calm down. It felt like they were just non-stop. Look at this, do you remember this, do you remember that sort of thing, which is cool enough, but I feel like it was getting to the point where it didn't really make a whole lot of sense that this many stuff, or that this much stuff would be referenced, I guess. Where, like, in that sense, I'm kind of referring to things like Captain America's shield and Thor's hammer. I don't know why the Collector would have those, so I mean, I guess that could be another what-if scenario, seeing how he got them. But we also, the soundtrack was something that was one of my favorite things about the first episode. I loved how they kind of redid the soundtrack from Captain America the First Avenger in like a new way. After the first like 15 minutes of this episode, I was kind of a little disappointed that they didn't really do the same thing here. We didn't hear the soundtrack of Black Panther, or we didn't hear the soundtrack of Guardians of the Galaxy, but they did start to bring that back towards the end, not to the degree that we saw in the first episode, but still got to see a lot of it, or hear a lot of it, I should say, which was really, really, really good. But yeah, it was another good episode. I really liked it. Some small nitpicks, but overall, I'm digging this. I actually kind of like the animation more this time than I did last time, which probably is because this was so space-fueled, kind of, like, very cosmic, so it kind of worked in that sense. But yeah, how did you feel about the episode? Did you like it? Did you hate it? And if you enjoyed this video, please remember to like, share, subscribe, and all of that, and I hope you have a great day.